The survey is the gloomiest produced by the London Chamber of Commerce during the current economic crisis. It indicates further deterioration in the capital's economy, with output falling to a new low, accelerating job losses and dwindling investment. Unemployment levels in London are the highest in the country and look set to remain so for the rest of the year. A quarter of companies are expected to shed jobs by Christmas. The London Chamber of Commerce believes the situation will get worse and says the capital's businessmen have no confidence in the government.
The most fundamental thing that the businesses need at the moment is confidence. They need to know very clearly what current government economic policy is going to be over the short term and the medium term so that they can start to plan positively for the future in terms of investment output and in terms of developing export markets. In conjunction with that, we also need to see another reduction in interest rates as quickly as possible.
Against the background of spiralling unemployment, the London Enterprise Agency and Capital Radio have launched an initiative to help people, particularly the jobless, set up their own businesses.
It's going to be tough now for the rest of this decade. So we've got to help them start and get ready for anything that might come at them and take the opportunities that can come to them. And then we give further help after they've started. We provide premises, we help with getting into export, things like that.
Actress and businesswoman Jane Asher and fashion designer Bruce Oldfield, who've both overcome business problems, were on hand to offer advice to would-be entrepreneurs.
Don't be tempted to diversify and expand into areas that are possibly better covered by other people. Stick to your own vision, the thing that you know you do best.
Watch your expenditure like a hawk. You know, don't think that if you need three meters of cloth, don't buy 3 meters 10. You know, because that 10 is just wastage. It's sitting there. You know, it could be in your pocket as money.
Despite the economic gloom, some businesses are thriving. Adam Gardner's company makes juggling equipment and is recruiting extra staff to meet rapidly expanding home and export markets.
The company's turning over £2 million a year at the moment, and we employ 30 people full-time and another 30 part-time. So it's doing fairly well. We're teaching England to juggle slowly.
Advice on how to succeed in business without juggling is available in the foyer at Capital Radio all week. This is Jane Ball for Thames News.